Hello students, hope you all are doing great. Today we are going to start a new chapter, that is changing families. In this video we will learn about some changes that occur in different families. But before that, let's revise types of families. We have already studied about three types of families. They are nuclear family, big family, joint family. Nuclear family is also known as small family, and it consists of two parents and one child or two children. Whereas big family consists of two parents, their children and their grandparents. Joint family consists of two parents, their children, their uncle and aunt, and grandparents. This chapter tells us about the changing families through the stories of Nimmi, Sering, and Nazli. First, we'll start with Nimmi's story. A new arrival. There is great excitement in Nimmi's family. She has a new baby sister. So you have seen a new baby is born in Nimmi's family. Her family went to the hospital. They met mother and daughter. Then they returned back to home. Nimmi was quite happy and excited to see her baby sister. Here we have seen some changes in Nimmi's family. There were four members before the arrival of baby sister. Father, Nimmi, grandmother, mother. But now one more member is added to the family. That is her baby sister. So in this way, Nimmi's family has changed with the arrival of a baby. Let's move to the next story. Sering's story. New place. Sering's father received a letter from his office. The letter said that he was being promoted and would have to move to another city. Yes. Sering's father has received a letter from his office. He has got promotion and he has to shift to another city. As he got letter, he gave this news to his family that he has got promotion and been transferred. The family started for him. City. Now, some changes occur in Sering's family also. Before his father got transferred, there were five members in the family. Grandfather, grandmother, father, mother, and Sering. But now, his father has left the family for the job. Four members are left only. So this is the story of Sering. Now we will move to the next story. Nazli's story. It's a wedding. There is great joy in Nazli's home today. Her elder cousin brother is getting married. We can see how Nazli's family has changed after her cousin got married. So, changes happen in families due to many reasons like birth, transfer, marriages, etc. Now, we will read the story of Ranga Reddy district. Yes, this district is in Telangana state. There are many girls who get married before they are 18 years old. Many of them have to even leave school. बहुत सारी ऐसी लड़कियां होती हैं जो 18 साल की उम्र से पहले ही उनकी शादी कर दी जाती है और उन्हें अपनी पढ़ाई तक छोड़नी पड़ जाती है. There are many true stories of girls like Sushila of Ranga Reddy district who are going back to school. She also got the help of the panchayat. Sushila जैसी ही कई दूसरी लड़कियों की भी सच्ची कहानियां हैं जो कि दोबारा से स्कूल जा रही हैं. सुशीला जो कि रंगा रेड्डी डिस्ट्रिक्ट की लड़की थी उसकी शादी कर दी गई थी लेकिन पंचायत की हेल्प से उसको दोबारा स्कूल जाने का मौका मिलता है. द पंचायत सेड दैट यंग चिल्ड्रन शुड प्ले एंड स्टडी एंड नॉट बी मैरिड ऑफ. पंचायत कहती है कि बच्चों को खेलना और पढ़ना चाहिए ना कि उनकी शादी करनी चाहिए. A group of people of Andhra Pradesh holds special camps to help married girls to go back to school. Jangamma and Chitti say, "We would like to study and stand on our own feet." So, this story, this incident happened in 2005 when Telangana and Andhra Pradesh were not separated. So, that time Ranga Reddy was in आंध्र प्रदेश. तो वहाँ पे जो लोग थे कुछ कैंप चलाते थे जिसमें जो शादीशुदा लड़कियाँ होती थी, बच्चियाँ जिनकी शादी कर दी जाती थी, उन्हें दोबारा स्कूल जाने का मौका मिलता था. सुशीला की तरह ही जंगम्मा और चिट्टी जो थी वो भी बोलती थी कि हमें पढ़ाई करनी है और अपने पैरों पर खड़े होना है. What is Child Marriage Act? Child marriage has been declared illegal according to the provisions of the Prohibition of Child Marriage Act, PCMA 2006. 2006 में ही ये एक्ट लागू किया गया था जिसमें चाइल्ड मैरिज यानी कि जो बच्चों का विवाह कर दिया जाता है उसे गैर कानूनी माना गया है और इस पे रोक लगाई गई है. It also includes the prohibition of marriages between children below the age of 18 for a girl and the age of 21 for a boy. इस एक्ट में बताया गया है कि एक लड़के की शादी 21 साल के नीचे नहीं की जा सकती और एक लड़की की शादी 18 उम्र से नीचे नहीं की जा सकती. So, ये एक्ट लगा था सुशीला के जो इंसिडेंट हुआ था उसी के बाद से. 2005 में वो इंसिडेंट हुआ और ये एक्ट आया 2006 में. एंड देन द गर्ल्स गेट चांस टू कंटिन्यू देयर स्टडीज. दैट्स ऑल इन दिस चैप्टर. थैंक यू. स्टे सेफ, स्टे हेल्दी.